I think at that time, I think that I thought that there was going to be an infinite number of questions to ask. And there were, and actually I asked and answered quite a few of them. For instance, to give you an example, my old professor, Cap Weston, used to in his lectures say, why is it that little fungi, and its thymols do the same thing, stick up at right ankles from the substratum? And this is true if you put them this way, or if you try to change it, because it's not a gravity thing. What is it? And what I was able to show a few years later was that these cell masses give off ammonia, and ammonia is a substance which they abhor, so they try and go away from it. So if you're going away from it and you have a situation where there's some produced in each side, then what you get is you get a stalk in bisecting the perfectly perpendicular, or you can put it in a cliff of agar. And if you put it here, then it'll not touch the walls, but it'll get right between the two sides of the wall, of the cave. And then that was before we knew it was ammonia. And then we did some very clever experiments trying to prove that. That turned out mostly to be that you have a little chamber which you put a block of agar near a hole. Now this is a closed-in plastic box, and with one hole in it, and you put the slime mold so that if this is a hole, the slime mold would be this way, and it would. I'm not sure this is going to show in my fat hands, but any event, if you had that hole and it was had ammonia on the outside, then the fruiting body would not go up, but would go down. But if you had nothing there, then it would go up. So in other words, it would always go whether there was less ammonia. A physical chemist friend of mine pointed out the fact that I was just at the limit of the size of the chambers to make this work on a theoretical basis. But that's okay, it worked.